How you doing there, folks? This upcoming Sunday, April 7th, we will celebrate 36 years in business. And I'm going to kind of take this week to reflect on this, some of it, the highlights, the low times, the up times, but more importantly, just hopefully to inspire and motivate people who want to go in business or those who are in business and wondering, man, did I make the right decision? And just want to kind of take you on a 36-year journey. And I just look back. I'm the reluctant entrepreneur. I really didn't plan on doing this, but opportunity came up and I took it. But also I had a family to take care of. That was always been my motivation. But when I started this business, I was a month short of my 32nd birthday. So I was a 31-year-old who had never ran anything. I'd been a project manager and an estimator, but it was so much I didn't know. And Carla and I just hung in there together. But there's a couple of key things that really helped. I never had a lifestyle to provide for Carla that, you know, like I had to make X amount of dollars. She did not mind struggling with me. So for those of you who are going in business or in business with, and you have a spouse or significant other, you both got to be on the same page, because I tell you, it makes a big difference when somebody's supporting you. But I remember signing that first contract for $88,000. And man, I was so nervous and scared. Now, the year before, we had a company, C.D. Moody & Associates, that my dad had started. He just incorporated a company in case one of us wanted to go in business, me or my, you know, my brothers. And I used that company, and that project went well. And I decided, hey, I'm gonna go in business for myself, because I'd have to put up performance bonds and things like that. So realistically, entrepreneurship started in 87, but C.D. Moody Incorporated 1988. And our first contract was $88,000 at Underground Atlanta, made about $3,000-$4,000. And it was pile caps and auger cast piles for a foundation. And in the beginning, we did a lot of subcontract work in concrete and foundations, and just kind of kept going. Didn't know what I didn't know. And when you start a business undercapitalized, you're in survival mode. And I stayed in survival mode far too long. And a lot has to do with what I was dealing with in mental health too, with dealing with a childhood trauma that I'll talk more about in a few days. But in the beginning, it was just Carl and I trying to figure it out. She went back to nursing school so we can have a steady income. So we had the first 2 years of business. She was also going to nursing school, and she finished in 1990. And we had two little kids. And I think back, man, God had a plan for me, because I don't know how we made it. But also, I think God wanted me to build a platform that I could help people deal with mental health from trauma, panic attacks, and anxiety that is brought on often by trauma or sometimes heredity for anxiety. So I just want to share over these next few days, because as you age, you tend to look back and realize, man, what a journey, what we've gone through. And to start a business 36 years ago, and we're just hoping we can make it a few years. And for me, I just wanted to make it long enough that I wasn't an embarrassment to my family. But I also used my family as my drive. I always said, I can't let them down. So that was always my motivation. It was never money. It was about, I just wanted to be able to provide for my family. So over this next week, I'm going to take you on a 36-year journey and talk about when I almost had, when I was going to take some investors, and at the last minute, I changed my mind. I said I'll just struggle or end up going out of business. But I'll tell you more about that. And one of them was actually Michael Jordan, the great Michael Jordan. I still got that picture that he autographed for me in 91. But I'll tell you a lot more over this next week and how important Carla's been on this journey. And again, I'll tell you, when you don't have a certain lifestyle that you have to provide for someone to be happy, makes life real easy. So we could struggle. So never give up, folks. Anybody wants to be an entrepreneur, hey, go for it. It's very rewarding, but it's very taxing on you. But it's a great thing, and I'm just so thankful that we're about to hit 36 years. Peace.